हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। आई एम मिसेस पल्लवी कुलकर्णी, हियर टू हेल्प यू टू सॉल्व चैप्टर वाइज असेसमेंट गिवन एट द एंड ऑफ ईच लेसन। एज अ साइंस टीचर, आई विल हेल्प यू टू गेट द मच नीडेड आंसर्स ऑफ एवरी क्वेश्चन ऑफ बोथ पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद स्टैंडर्ड 9, साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट। Part first, first lesson, that is laws of motion. Let's first see the very first question, that is question number 1. The question is, match the first column with appropriate entries in the second and third columns and remake the table. Let's see what the table says. As you see in the table, there are 4 columns, serial number, column 1, 2 and 3. The column 1 has types of accelerations given. Column 2 contains the definitions of these acceleration. And column 3 contains the examples of those types of accelerations. So what is given here? You have to match the column 1 with column 2 and column 1, 2 with column 3. So here, the table it is given. Now let's see what is the proper answer. So here is the answer table. See, column number 1, it is negative acceleration. What is the definition of negative acceleration? Whenever the velocity of object decreases, it is called as negative acceleration. So here in column 2, if you see, I have matched the proper definition with the proper this negative acceleration with its proper definition. And if you see the column 3, I have properly matched with the example. See, a vehicle moving with the velocity of 10 meter per second stops after 5 seconds. That means the velocity initially it was 10 meter per second, and after 5 seconds the velocity decreases to 0 meter per second. Okay, that means a vehicle is having negative acceleration. If you see second number, that is positive acceleration, and see the column 2, I have matched with the definition. The velocity of object increases. Positive acceleration means what? When the velocity of object increases, it is said to be in positive acceleration. See the example. A car initially at rest reaches a velocity of 50 km per hour in 10 seconds. So a car initially at rest means what? The velocity of car initially it was 0 meter per second. And the velocity after increasing, it becomes 50 km per hour in 10 seconds. That means velocity increases. So it is an example of positive acceleration. Let's see the third point, that is zero acceleration. When can we say that the acceleration is zero? Whenever there is no change in the velocity. Okay? Whenever there is no change in velocity, we can call that particular object is said to be in zero acceleration. So I have matched with the definition. See the definition, the velocity of an object remains constant. That means does not change. Okay, the example is a vehicle moving with velocity of 25 meter per second. That means it is moving with the constant speed of 25 meter per second. The velocity does not increasing here and it is neither decreasing. Okay, that means this is the answer table of the question number 1. Question number 2 is clarify the differences. That means you have to tell the difference between the two things. The first one is distance and displacement. You have to tell the difference between distance and displacement. We know that there is little bit similarities between distance and displacement. Okay. So if such a questions will come in the exam, it will come for 2 marks for sure. Okay. So for these 2 marks, you need to write 4 points. Always remember, the difference between means the distinguish between these questions, such a questions will come for 2 marks and you need to write the 4 points for 2 marks. That means 2 points for 1 mark. Okay. So let's see the points of differentiation between distance and displacement. The first point is, actually it should be a definition always. Okay. If the term has any definition, you should write the first point of definition. Okay, so here I have written the definition of distance and displacement. The first point is, distance is actual path length between the start point and the end point. Okay, and what is the definition of displacement? displacement is the shortest distance between start point and the end point. Okay, this is the main difference between distance and displacement. Though their unit of measurement is the same, they have the little bit difference in between them. Okay, this is the main difference. The second point is, it is scalar quantity, that means distance is scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. So what is scalar quantity and what is vector quantity? Okay, in earlier standards we have studied about the scalar quantities and vector quantities. Scalar quantities is nothing but the quantities that does not need to set the direction. Okay, and vector quantities always require direction as well as magnitude to tell. Okay, so whenever you are dealing with the distances, you need not to tell in what direction you are measuring the distance, but if you are considering the direction, that means you are telling about the displacement. Okay, that means distance is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. See the third point. Distance is always has some positive value. Means if you are measuring some path length, that means if you are measuring some distances, its value must be some positive value. Okay, it should not be zero or it should not be any negative value. But when you are measuring displacement, its value may be positive or zero. Okay, that means though the object is covering some distance, it may have the zero displacement. Okay, as in the case of circular path, if the object has start point and finish point is same, that means the object have covered some distance but its displacement is same as the start point and the end point is same. Okay, see the fourth point. Distance is always greater than or equal to displacement. And in the fourth point of displacement, says the reverse point. Displacement is always less than or equal to distance. That means displacement is either equal to distance or it is less than the distance. Okay, it never be greater than distance. Displacement never be greater than distance. Okay, if you want to take down the points, you can pause the video and you can take down the points. Okay, let's move to the second point. The second question in clarify the difference is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. First one is the definition. The definition of uniform motion is, if a body covers equal distance in equal interval of time, it is said to be in uniform motion. And the definition of non-uniform motion is, if a body covers unequal distance in equal interval of time, it is said to be in non-uniform motion. See here, in both the cases, the time interval is taken equal. But in uniform motion, the distance is also covered equal. But in non-uniform motion, the distance cover is unequal. That is the main difference between uniform motion and non-uniform motion. The second point of differentiation is, here the distance time graph is straight line. And here in non-uniform motion, the distance time graph is curved line. We have seen the example of Amar, Akbar, Anthony in our textbook. We have drawn the graph also and we got the results also. Okay, so we know the graph is straight line in the case of uniform motion and it is curved line in the case of non-uniform motion. Now, third point is, in uniform motion, the acceleration is zero. Means what? As the body is covering equal distance in equal interval of time, it is not changing its velocity at all. If the velocity is not changing, means what? The acceleration is zero. Okay? And in the case of non-uniform motion, as the velocity is changing, the acceleration is non-zero. Okay? The fourth point is, vehicle is traveling on straight empty road. And the example of non-uniform motion is, vehicle is traveling on crowded road. In question number 3, our table is given. Table is divided into 3 different parts. The first part I have written here. See, if you see the table, the columns in the table, it is a numerical examples. In first column, the value of u is given. Second column, value of a is given. Third column, the value of t is given. And in the last column, a formula is given. Okay, by using that formula, you have to solve the numerical. See, first I have solved. The first is v is equal to u plus at. The value of u is 2. Value of a is 4. Value of t is 3. By using the formula, 2 plus 4 into 3, 2 plus 12,
इज इक्वल टू 14 मीटर पर सेकेंड. ओके, द वैल्यू ऑफ फर्स्ट द वैल्यू ऑफ फर्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल कम्स 14 मीटर पर सेकेंड. ओके, देन द सेकेंड वन, हियर द वैल्यू ऑफ यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट वैल्यू ऑफ ए टी एंड वी इज गिवन. देयर फोर वी हैव टू प्लेस ऑल द वैल्यूज एंड बाय प्लेसिंग ऑल द वैल्यूज वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट यू. सी आई हैव कैलकुलेटेड द वैल्यू ऑफ यू कम्स 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड. ओके, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कॉपी इट दिस वन, पॉज द वीडियो एंड यू कैन राइट द एग्जाम्पल. इन द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द टेबल v square is equal to u square plus 2as formula we have to use. See the first example, u, a, v value are given, s value you have to calculate. By putting all the values, the s value came 8 meter. In the second example, a, s, v values are given, u value you have to calculate. By putting all the values, the value of u came 4 meter per second. Every time I am telling again, you have to see for the unit, don't forget to write the unit. This is the second part of table. Here S is displacement. U, A, T and S values are given and you have to calculate by using S is equal to UT plus half AT square formula. The first example, if you see, U, A and T values are given and S value you have to calculate. Okay. So according to the formula S is equal to UT plus half AT square, I have put all the values and the value of S came 69. As S is a displacement, its unit is meter. Don't forget to write units all the time. In the second example, the value of A have to calculate. So I have put all the values in the formula and I have calculated A as 8 meter per second. Okay, see here properly and you can take down how I have solved. The next question is complete the sentence and explain them. So you have to fill in the blanks only. Okay, first one, the minimum distance between the start and finish point and of motion of an object is called dash of the object. So the answer is displacement. This is the definition of displacement. Okay, so the next one is deceleration is dash acceleration. It is negative acceleration. So negative acceleration is also called as the deceleration. It is given in the textbook. C, when an object is in uniform circular motion, its direction changes at every point. So direction changes at every point. How the direction changes at every point? See, in the circular motion, whenever object is at particular place, its direction is tangential to that particular point. Okay, when it shifts to next point, it is again shifted its direction and its direction become to tangential to that particular point. So like that, the direction is continuously changed when object is in uniform circular motion. Okay, so next is during collision, dash remains constant, so it's total momentum. It is according to the Newton's second law of motion. So what the second law of motion tells? See, whenever there is any collision, the total momentum before collision is always equal to the total momentum after collision. Okay, so this is according to the Newton's second law of motion. The next is the working of rocket depends on Newton's dash law of motion. So it is the Newton's third law of motion. What the Newton's third law of motion says? For every action, there is always equal and opposite reaction. So in the rocket, the same principle is using. Okay, that's why the answer is third law of motion. Question number 5 gives scientific reason. First one, when an object falls freely to the ground, its acceleration is uniform. So the reason is, first one, acceleration is said to be uniform when an object travels with equal change. Change here, the change is either increasing or decreasing in velocity in equal interval of time, right? So this is the definition of uniform acceleration. So the second one, when object falls freely, gravitational force acts on it, pulling it downward, right? So the third point, in this case, velocity changing by uniform rate. So whenever object is falling freely from upward to downward direction, its velocity is continuously getting increased in equal interval of time, right? This is the only reason that this motion we can say that it is accelerated, it is uniform accelerated motion. Okay, therefore when an object falls freely to the ground, its acceleration is said to be uniform. Second question, even though the magnitudes of action force and reaction force are equal and their directions are opposite, their effect do not cancel Okay, so what is the meaning of the question? See, in the first point only the meaning of the question you will come to know. When the two equal and opposite forces are acting on the same object, they cancel their effect. Okay, so the meaning of the question is, though the magnitude and direction of reaction and action force are same, okay, then also why they do not cancel their effect, why they act on each other. Okay, this is the meaning of the question. So the second point is, it is a point of actual reason, but in the above case, action force is acting on object 1 and the reaction force is acting on object 2. That is, both of them are acting on two different objects. See here, if the forces are acting on the same object, then only they can cancel. But if they are acting on the different object, they will not get cancelled to each other. Okay, so that's why their effects do not get cancelled. Here I have drawn the diagram. See, object 1 and object 2. Object 2 applies action force on object 1. And object 1 applies reaction force on object 2. Here it is clearly understand that two different objects are involved. That's why they do not cancel their effect, though they have same magnitude and opposite direction. The next question is, it is easier to stop tennis ball as compared to cricket ball when both are traveling with the same velocity. The reason is, first one, we know that momentum is equal to mass into velocity. Second, if any one quantity from mass or velocity is more, its momentum is more. Third one, in the above case, though the velocity of both the balls are same, their masses are different. And the last point, mass of cricket ball is more, therefore its momentum is more, and hence the force required to catch of that particular ball is more. Hence, it is easy to stop tennis ball than the cricket ball. The last and fourth question. The velocity of an object at rest is considered to be uniform. Why? First point. An object is in uniform motion when it is moving with a constant speed. An object at rest has a constant velocity of 0 meter per second. Obviously, as it is not moving, that means its speed is 0 meter per second and it is constant till it is at resting position. Okay, hence the velocity of an object at rest is considered to be uniform. Next question, question number 6. Take 5 examples from your surroundings and give explanation based on Newton's laws of motion. The first example is, the gun recoils when bullet is fired. The explanation is that according to the Newton's third law of motion, if gun apply action force on bullet also applies reaction force on it, so it gets recoiled. The second example, when jerk is given to the carpet, dust particles get separated. Explanation is that, as per Newton's first law of motion, dust particles are in a state of inertia. So, when jerk is given to the carpet, it moves. But the dust particles try to remain at their position and get separated from the carpet. Third example is, an air balloon, if released, moves forward. Explanation, as per Newton's third law of motion, air is released from balloon and apply force in backward direction, and air in turn applies equal and opposite force to balloon in forward direction. The fourth example, while catching ball, cricketer moves his hands backward. Explanation, by taking longer time to stop the ball, he reducing the rate of change of momentum and thereby not hurting his hands. This is according to the Newton's second law of motion. The last and fifth example is firing of the rocket. Explanation, during firing of the rocket, tremendous fire is applied force in downward direction. Hence, an equal and opposite force is applied on the rocket to make it fly high in the sky. This is according to the Newton's third law of motion. Let's move to the next question, question number 7. Solve the following examples. Okay, the first one is, an object moves 18 meter in first 3 seconds, 22 meters in next 3 seconds, and 14 meter in the last 3 seconds. What is the average speed? So let's see what are the given things. Distance 1, that is d1, is 18 meter. Distance 2 is 22 meter. Distance 3 is 14 meter. Here, time 1 is 3 seconds, 2 is also 3 seconds, and time 3 is also 3 seconds. So, what formula we have to use here? Formula is average speed is equal to total distance upon total time. Here, total distance is 18 plus 22 plus 14 divided by total time is 3 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 54 upon 9 is equal to 6 meter per second. See, here we are calculating speed and the unit of speed is meter per second. Therefore, don't forget to write the units every time. If you forget to write the unit, it will reduce your mark. Okay, you will lose your marks here. So, don't forget to write the units. Okay, so the final answer we have to write in the form of words. Okay, in the word form, you have to write the final answer because the question is also in the word form. Right, so the answer is average speed of object is 6 meter per second. Try to highlight the final answer. Okay. Moving to the next example, an object of mass 16 kg is moving with an acceleration of 3 meter per second square. Calculate the applied force. If the same force is applied on an object of mass 24 kg, how much will be the acceleration? So what are the given things? Mass of first object, that is M1, is 16 kg. Acceleration of first object, that is A1, is 3 meter per second square. Mass of the second object, that is M2, is 24 kg. What is to be find here? First one, applied force, that is F, which is common for both the cases. Second, acceleration of the second object, that is A2. So here we are using formula F is equal to M into A, that is mass into acceleration. Therefore, F is equal to M1 into A1, that is F is equal to 16 into 3 is equal to 48 N. N is Newton. It is a unit of force. As the same force is applied on the second object, F is equal to M2 into A2, that is 48 that we have calculated already above, is equal to 24 into A2. Here A2 is equal to 48 upon 24. The answer is 2 meter per second square. So the final answer became, the applied force is equal to 48 Newton and the acceleration of second object is 2 meter per second square. Don't forget to write the units of all the quantities. Okay. The third example is a bullet having a mass of 10 gram and moving with a speed of 1.5 meter per second penetrates a thick wooden plank of mass 90 gram. The plank was initially at rest. The bullet gets embedded in the plank and both moves together. So determine their velocity. So we have to determine the common velocity of bullet and plank. Okay. Let's see the given things first. Mass of the bullet. It is given 10 gram. Let's convert it into kilogram. It is 10 raised to minus 2 kilogram. Okay. Then initial speed of bullet, that is VB. Here it is considering velocity of bullet. Okay. It is 1.5 meter per second. Mass of wooden plank, that is MW. It is 90 gram. Let's convert it into kilogram. It is 9 into 10 raised to minus 2 kilogram. Initial speed of a plank. It is given 0 because plank was at rest initially. Therefore, the speed was 0. The formula we are using is MBVB plus MWVW is equal to MBV plus MWV. So, what is the meaning of that? So, what we are doing here? We are taking total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. So total momentum before collision means what? So mass and velocity of box plus mass and velocity of wooden plank. Sorry, it is not box, it is bullet. Mass and velocity of bullet plus mass and velocity of box, that is wooden plank, is equal to mass and velocity of bullet plus mass and velocity of plank. Here velocity of box and velocity of plank after collision is common because they move together after the collision, right? That's why. So here in the next step, I have taken V as a common because it is same. So in the again next step, I have put all the values in the formula. Okay, and then after solving I got V is equal to 0.15 meter per second. So how to write the final answer? Common velocity of bullet and plank is 0.15 meter per second. Remember here, you are using the formula of total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum of after collision. And the formula of momentum is mass into velocity. The last example is, a person swims 100 meter in first 40 second, 80 meter in next 40 second and 45 meter in the last 20 second. What is the average speed? The example is exactly similar to the first example that we have solved. The given things, distance 1, 100 meter, distance 2, 80 meter, distance 3, 45 meter. Time 1, 40 second, time 2, 40 second, time 3 is 20 second. The same formula we have to use here, average speed is equal to total distance upon total time. That is equal to 100 plus 80 plus 45 divided by 40 plus 40 plus 20. 225 upon 100 is equal to 2.25 meter per second. This is the average speed of the person. So the final answer I have highlighted here. This was the last example. Here the exercise is finished. Okay. So dear student, if you have any doubt, you can write your doubt in the comment box. Subscribe the video to get the new video updates to you. And share the videos more and more so that it will reach to the needy students. Okay? Thank you. Thanks a lot.